fam, it's your girl Mimi, the Frenchie Queen, back at it with another video. Before we get started, look at this amazing t-shirt that I have on. I just wanted to give a quick little shout out to Ron Ramos, Papa Pitt. He is an amazing judge, known all over the world, and he gave me this amazing t-shirt. I know he has them for sale. I will add his Instagram down below so that you guys can send him a message and get you one of these t-shirts. But yeah, guys, let's get into our video and let's see why you should not be breeding dogs. Three reasons why. Rule number one, the market is oversaturated. That is one thing that I cannot describe to you guys, how insane. Before, my litters were literally sold before I even had them. And now I'm at a point where I'm holding on to my puppies a lot longer. I'm having a really hard time being able to sell them. And also, I am skipping my females' heats just because I don't feel like, how am I gonna have another litter and it's hard selling my puppies. So I've been skipping a lot of heats, and I know that a lot of my breeder friends have been doing the same. So yeah, that is rule number one, that the market is oversaturated, and it's something that we have been dealing with for, I wanna say, quite a while. COVID ruined the dog industry. It is what it is, guys, but yeah, that's rule number one. Rule number two, it's extremely expensive to breed dogs. So first you have to get progesterone test to test your female to see when she's going to be ready to get bred. Normally my test, when I get them done, I probably get anywhere from 2 to 5 progesterone tests before I actually breed my female. Each test costs about $60 to $100 depending on where you live. And after you do that, then you have to get the stud. Once your female is ready, you get the stud, right? So the stud is going to cost you anywhere from $2,000 to $10,000, just depending on the stud that you want to use and what bloodlines you want to bring into your breeding program. So you got your PG test, where you're normally spending anywhere from $100 to $300. Then you got your stud. The stud owner should be able to provide the AI service, which is artificial insemination, which is basically where they grab a straw, put it inside of the vagina, the female's vagina, and then insert the semen. So if your breeder does not provide that, the stud service, then you have to pay for that yourself at a local vet or at a reproduction clinic. Oh my goodness, I could not say that word. And then, if your female, say her numbers are too high, and you have to do a TCI. TCIs, I think they're $150 to $200 each one, or you're going to have to do a surgical, which is basically a small incision in the mama's belly, and they put the babies directly into her stomach, kind of like IVF. So that procedure, I think it's anywhere from $250 to $400, depending on your vet and where you're located. So yeah, guys, that's already a pretty little penny. And then you still have to get all the whelping supplies. So at this point, you've probably already spent upwards to $5,000, including the stud, the PGs, the reverse PGs. I forgot to mention that you have to get reverse progesterone tests on your females right before they have the puppies to make sure it's a good time to pull them out. So yeah, guys, breeding is very, very expensive, and there's no guarantee that your puppies will survive. There's no guarantee that you're going to sell your puppies, and there's no guarantee your puppies will come out healthy, because there's things you have to worry about, such as like cleft palates. And on top of that, you can just have a singleton, just one puppy, just one. And that's just kind of like, hey, you just took a loss. Like, you didn't even make what you were supposed to make. Say you have 4 puppies and you're like, oh my goodness, I got all lilacs and I'm gonna sell each one for, you know, $8,000 each one. Well, turns out the market isn't doing good. It's not thriving. So everybody is lowballing you, and everybody's trying to give you $3,000 for your puppies. So what are you going to do? You're not going to make that expected money that you thought you were going to make. So it's just always a gamble when you're breeding dogs. You don't know what's going to happen. Always expect the unexpected when breeding dogs. Rule number three is you cannot leave your house. I know this one sounds crazy, but it's true. Trust me when I tell you, you cannot leave your house when you are a dog breeder. So I have 5 dogs here, and one female went into heat. All right, cool, I'm gonna breed her. And then the next thing you know, my other female goes into heat. So it's like, okay, I'm going to have two dogs that I'm going to breed. And then I think about the timeline. And I'm like, wait, I'm supposed to go on vacation with my family at this time. Guess what? You can't go. I can't go. I have to stay behind, take care of the dogs, take care of the puppies. And yeah, my whole family gets to go on an amazing trip. And I just get to stay home and get left behind and just take care of dogs all day. But I don't mind it because I love my dogs. I love my animals and I love what I do for a living. So yeah, guys, that is one of the things. You can't leave your house. Like, yes, I could leave my house to go to the grocery store, come back, but I always have to come back. So with French Bulldogs, they are a flat-faced breed and they need to be inside of the house with the AC on. And when you own more than five dogs, it gets a little crazy. You can't just have a bunch of dogs roaming around inside your house. So you have to keep them in kennels. So you have to keep them in a kennel, then go out, do whatever you gotta do, come back home to let them out. So it's not like, hey, I'm going to go to my mom's house and go visit her for the day and have a barbecue with my family, because guess what? I have to come back home and let the dogs out to go use the restroom and then bring them back into their kennel or just let them free roam. So it's just a lot. What I mean, you can really cannot leave your house. Going on vacation is really hard. It's really expensive because as for me, I have to have somebody come to my house and take care of my dogs. And just telling somebody like, hey, can you come take care of my five dogs? Like, that's really hard. Like, oh, this one eats this, this one doesn't eat that. These two get along, these two don't get along. So it's really hard. It's really a lot to own multiple dogs, especially when some of them don't get along. So yeah, guys, there's a lot of things that go into play with breeding dogs. Another thing that I forgot to mention is reproduction. A lot of people don't look into this as much, but reproduction is not guaranteed at all. So when it comes to your female, you could breed her a bunch of times and she just won't take. I have a friend that had a female that she told me, she's like, Mimi, I bred this dog every single which way you think I could breed her and she wouldn't get pregnant. She said she tried breeding her four times and she wouldn't get pregnant. So she finally just had to fix her and pet home the female. And that also applies to the male dog. You could have a male dog with bad semen, very low count for the mobility, not a lot of swimmers, low on the semen. Yeah, so there's just a lot of issues that come with dog breeding. And if you're not ready for all these issues, then you might want to reconsider becoming a dog breeder. All right, guys, if you just finished watching this video and you're like, you know what, I could totally do all these things and more, and I don't mind staying home, and I don't mind spending a bunch of money on vet bills, then by all means, become a dog breeder and just make sure you follow me for more educational videos on dog breeding. All right, guys, I love you and I'll see you on the next one. Love you.